Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another bite-sized speed build. Now, to be honest with you guys, I do think I have to change the name of this series because this build is not small by any means. But of course, as you can tell from the title of today's video, we are working on an underground train station in the world of Mount Komorebi. Now, I'm sure you guys know we don't really have any cool ways of traveling or transporting ourselves in The Sims 4. We don't really have cars, they kind of just zip around, and unfortunately, we're just forced to use our smartphone on location to go to another world. But for this build, I wanted to integrate some kind of unique gameplay and have sort of a semi-functional train station, if you will. And for this build, I obviously chose the world of Mount Komorebi. So we do have a pretty interesting theme here. The train station itself is kind of a merging of Western train stations with more of a Japanese influence, if that makes sense. But hopefully the Japanese style of this build is still versatile in other worlds as well. If you do want to create connecting train stations and possibly just modify some bits of the exterior, I think this could be a really fun lot for your game. But anyways, here we are. I'm just kind of putting down the main shell of the build itself. I did create a little bit of an overhang moment towards the front, which was fairly characteristic of train stations I have seen in real life. Now, apart from the train station itself, this will also be a retail lot. So this will house a bookstore on the right side and also a cafe on the left as well. The fun part of this build is actually selling tickets, which I kind of had to get creative with. When we do get to the inside, you'll see that I actually use these folder objects from the Get to Work pack. So those are going to be the train tickets per se. And I imagine that if you bring your Sims there, you can pick different tickets up, you can purchase them, and then travel to your desired destination in The Sims 4. So that's kind of the gameplay element I have going here. But anyways, just speaking to the outside, I'm using a lot of I'm using a lot of Snowy Escape, Island Living eventually, and also Base Game. So I do line these walkways with a lot of the Snowy Escape fence pieces and also the Base Game rocks as well. One thing I really do love are actually these trees from the Island Living pack, and I believe they're called poinciana trees. I'm probably wrong on that, but I do like the very autumnal feel that they have. They do kind of remind me of cherry blossoms as well, so I do really enjoy those objects. Now, I will say, you guys, I actually had a very hard time choosing packs for this build. Originally, you did see me use a little bit of Seasons, in terms of the doors and also the signage as well. But this build will use Get Together, Get to Work, Snowy Escape, and Island Living for the end result. Moving on to the inside now, we are looking at the central office area. So this will be where you will eventually pick up your ticket, and from there go to a variety of different places in this build. So if you are kind of using your imagination in the game, if your train ride is not quite ready yet, you can hang out at the cafe, the bookstore, or just head down to the underground train station area. But anyways, when I was researching train stations, I was coming across a lot of older, abandoned, or even more vintage retro buildings, if you will. So overall, I would say that the interior is a little bit more dated or rustic, I would say, and I definitely wanted to keep that aesthetic. This is the front desk area. I'm using a lot of the countertops from the Get to Work pack. And I will warn you guys, I do change out the lighting fixtures quite a bit in this build. I was really torn between going with a more Western look with some objects and then a more Eastern or Japanese influence as well. But eventually I do change those out. I am adding in these really cool clocks that I believe are from the Get to Work pack, and then pairing them with the signage from the Get to Work pack as well, if I do remember them correctly. So these could be different times. Maybe this could be a world clock area if you're looking at times in Paris, Tokyo, etc. And now, of course, you're seeing the little tickets come to life. I'm not really sure what train tickets look like, but unfortunately, this was one of the only objects I could find in game that you can actually purchase if you are running a retail establishment. And I figured that the different colors could represent different destinations. So maybe orange could be Sulani, maybe green could be Henford-on-Bagley. I'm going to let you guys use your imagination with that. Now, I will say from looking at references, The amount of benches and train stations was very high, so I definitely wanted to replicate that in this build. I'm using this option from the Snowy Escape pack and also using this little ottoman or chair object from the Island Living pack as well, but instead repurposing it as an end table. Going in, there are some additional details I do add. I really enjoy these poster sets from the Snowy Escape pack. But of course, I also changed out a lot of the light fixtures. Originally, I do believe I used the Get to Work lights, but again, I think I wanted to go for a more Japanese feel here. So I do use a mixture of the Snowy Escape lights and also ones from base game, kind of giving that shoji screen appearance, if you will. Now we're also seeing the cafe come to life. I'm using the signage from the Snowy Escape pack and very carefully placing it in the Snowy Escape spandrel as well. Now, I will say that if you do not want to use this lot as a retail lot per se, we do have the espresso bar from the Get Together pack as well. So that is a potential option. I do think retail is probably the way to go here if you want to maximize the sort of gameplay in this build, but I will leave that up to you guys in the end. Now, on that note, I will also add in a small kitchen here as well. So if you want to sell train tickets, if you want to sell books, or if you want to sell either prepared foods or baked goods, this would be a really cool lot to do so. Now, I try to keep the kitchen fairly industrial. We are working with a super cramped space because I completely overlooked this kitchen. I'm gonna admit that. I didn't think about having a kitchen in here originally, so the outside shell changes ever so slightly. But again, I think this is a really fun gameplay opportunity. We do have a lot of the basic fixtures here. So we do have a fridge, sink, I do have plenty of counter space, and I will add in a stove as well. And of course, these lovely anti-slip mats, I presume. I'm not really sure what they're called. But the fun part of this build, of course, is adding in all of those realistic details. So we do have a lot of get to work here. We do have the exit signs. I do put in a fire extinguisher, and I do use the sort of soap dispenser and paper towel object quite a bit as well. So hopefully this will be fun for your Sims if you are running this as a business. But of course, we are moving out to the cafe itself and sort of the main dining area. You guys did see I use a display case towards the right. So like I said, if you have a chef sim that wants to run the cafe, they can sell some prepared goods in that area as well. I will say the cafe is probably one of my favorite spots. I'm using these Norin screens, or Norin curtains, I should say. And I do think they add a very whimsical touch to this space. I definitely want it to feel very homey and warm to be here. So again, adding lots of nice clutter everywhere, especially from the Snowy Escape pack. I really enjoyed this sort of snow ski coat rack. I'm not really sure what the right terminology is, but you guys did see it there. I figured it would be nice to enjoy a hot cup of tea, maybe some pastries, while of course taking off your heavy coats and scarves while you do dine there. Moving back to the right side now, I am working on the public restrooms. So they're honestly not anything too fancy. I'm keeping a very similar industrial style to the kitchen, but of course they were essential to gameplay and this was probably the best area I could fit them within the build itself. So unfortunately the bookstore is just a little bit smaller. It's a very tight spot, but of course here is a look at the bathrooms themselves. And one trick I always like using is actually using taller partial walls to create the individual bathroom stalls. I'm pretty sure we do get bathroom stalls in either Discover University or high school years. Correct me if I'm wrong, I don't have all the packs, but I think you do have that object in there. But this, of course, is always my makeshift solution. Just going in now and adding some toilets, sinks. I do use the Get to Work objects once more with the soap dispenser and paper towel object, and then I also squeeze in a stainless steel trash can as well. Anyways, we are now moving on to the bookstore, and this was honestly a very hard space for me to design. It does go through some variations. I do change out a lot of the bookcases, and eventually I do have a nice window towards the back as well, which I do add in off screen. Obviously, we're working with a super narrow space, but I did want to maximize gameplay here, and you will eventually see me add in some individual books that I searched through in debug. I am currently adding in some cash registers. I completely forgot them at the front desk area, but there they are. I'm going to use this base game accent table, and this will pretty much be the display area for the books on sale. Of course, it was kind of a tedious process. I was kind of alt-placing the books in the appropriate position and then shifting that accent table back. So it looks like the books are kind of laid out on display. And to my knowledge, because these are not specifically debug books, your Sims will be able to purchase them as well. Trying to enhance the display, I'm also using this either base game or Get to Work bookcase. I'm not quite sure. I do believe it's from Get to Work, but correct me if I'm wrong. But of course, I am sizing them down and placing them on top of the accent tables as well. So I do think that they kind of fill the space better. It does make the bookstore seem a little bit more better stocked, if you will. So there is that. But of course, I am pulling some debug objects. I really enjoy these book display objects from the base game. So I do put a few on the counter space just like so. And finally, we are starting to move into the underground train station area. I'm going to put in two staircases leading up and down from this space, but I am going to create some elevators, which are very interesting. I don't think The Sims 4 has functional elevators to my knowledge, even with different packs. I do believe the most that they do is they transport your Sims from one floor to another. Whereas in The Sims 3, the elevators functioned really well. You could go up to, you know, individual floors or go down to certain floors. But, you know, we have to work with what we have in game. For the time being, these are more so placeholders, but I did want to keep that aspect of realism if we are making this place accessible for all Sims. Now, I will say, if you do want to create these in your game, they're not too hard. I do use the sliding doors from the Snowy Escape Pack. I do full-length mirrors from base game. I use the metal flooring from base game. And then the best thing I could find for the button panel was the police plaque. I think it works. Let me know if you guys think there is a better object, because, you know, I'm more than welcome to suggestions, but I think that was the best replication I could create. But anyways, we are moving downstairs to the actual underground train station. Now, normally I would have probably built this on the ground level floor, just like a real train station, but this design was probably more akin to a subway. I did need the trains to sort of disappear into a space, if that makes sense, or at least create somewhat of that illusion. I am adding in the debug train tracks that came with the Snowy Escape Pack, but for the train pieces themselves, I am pulling them from base game. So we do have what looks like sort of the passenger car or trolley car, if you will, and then the main part of the train itself going towards the right. Now the challenge, like I said, was creating the illusion of the train kind of disappearing into the ground, and we can't really do that in game. It doesn't just magically disappear off the lot, but I'm creating a darker stone texture or darker void towards the far right and far left sides, and eventually I am pulling these base game shelves as well. So I am sizing them up, I am pushing them up towards the ceiling, and hopefully that creates some kind of cover where the train could disappear into. So again, unfortunately, you have to use a little bit of imagination, but I think it should work out in the end. I am using the Get to Work lights as well, and these do stay here because they do have a very industrial quality that I did like about them. Now, I will admit something to you guys. I have actually never had the luxury of traveling via train. It sounds really fun. It sounds like a really cool experience, but for some reason, I've never had it. I've always flown by airplane or just driven somewhere by car, and I've even actually been on boats and cruises, but trains, unfortunately, are just not an experience I am very familiar with. So you did see I added some sort of guardrail towards the front. I imagine that this would be here for protective purposes for passengers, and it also would be a place where train station workers would verify a passenger's ticket before they actually boarded the train itself. So that's kind of what I garnered from some different examples. I did reference a lot of subways as well, but not all of them really functioned like this. But hopefully this does make sense. Of course, this is a waiting area, so we have tons of benches, again, from the Snowy Escape Pack. And I create this very interesting divider wall using columns and the sort of wooden slat windows from the Island Living Pack. Now, if you're feeling peckish, we do have some vending machines down here as well, and I also add in the get-to-work television screens. I figured that we needed some kind of screen somewhere. I know that they're very common throughout airports with a lot of the different airlines, the different flights, so I imagine that there is something similar to that in a train station, so I do include them here. Of course, like I said, I am swapping out the lights once more. But we now finished the build with the backyard outdoor space, and this was actually a really nice chill spot that I added here. Now, originally, I wasn't quite sure what to do with this space. I considered making it a second entrance, if that makes sense. But I figured, you know, if Sims are waiting for their train ride, this could be a really nice calm space to enjoy a meal or even play a game of chess. So currently, I'm just finishing a lot of the landscaping. I'm pulling a lot of the same debug objects from the Snowy Escape Pack. These beautiful, hopefully poinciana trees that look like cherry blossom trees, and also some base game flowers as well. I really enjoyed these white flowers that I believe are called hydrangeas. And funny enough, I actually remember them from Spirited Away, which of course is a wonderful film by Hayao Miyazaki. And I thought they fit really well here. Now, this funky tree I loved. I don't really know what the exact name for it is in game, but I have never used it in any of my builds, but it fits so well here. It's kind of a very manicured topiary tree, if that makes sense. And I'm just adding a few scatters of rocks from the base game as well, just to give the lot a little bit more of a organic feel, if that makes sense. Now, of course, I'm testing out the lighting situation at night, and I'm also adding in some matching sliding doors from the Snowy Escape Pack. So I'm going to bring out some base game here, or at least I think it's base game, but we do have some umbrella covered tables. So if you have a bite from the vending machine, if you have food from the cafe, you're more than welcome to eat it out here with your Sims. I'm also adding in these lovely flower beds from the Get Together pack and also pairing them with the sort of crawling ivy as well, almost as if the plants have kind of overgrown that pot and started crawling up the walls. I'm also bringing in these really cool wooden pieces from the Snowy Escape Pack. They work very well as trellises, but also really nice architectural elements. And yes, as promised, we do have a chess table here, so it's just another little activity. I didn't really have anything too particular in mind for this area, but that is pretty much it for the lot itself. Alright guys, and that is a wrap on the underground train station in the world of Mount Komorebi. As always, I really hope you guys enjoyed the build, and I do hope that if you do download this lot, it adds a nice layer of gameplay in The Sims 4, especially because we don't have any concrete means of transportation in-game. On that note, this is still a no CC, no mod, limited pack build, and will be available on The Sims 4 gallery for download. I'll leave you guys now with the final lot specs, along with the final cinematic shots, so you can see how everything turned out in the end. And of course, just like always, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.